Hey everyone, welcome back to Pine Hollow out of Diagnostics. Hey, Toyota Camry, it made it all the way to Texas and back. This is the one that we diagnosed the EGR problem on and also the oil leaks last year. So everything held up, the timing belt. Customer brought it in just to look it over after the long road trip. And she said that her airbag light came on. She wants that looked at. So let's dive right in. Fire this thing up. There's the airbag light. And sure enough, it's on. So in the scanner, we have the vehicle loaded. Airbag. Ooh. Connect the toy one adapter. Use a DA5 cable adapter, location box mark diagnosis under hood on either fender well. Please follow these two steps. If no communication with toy one adapter, try toy two adapter. Okay, looking at the toy one adapter, you might have to disconnect the jumper pin WA and WB if any applicable to this vehicle. Okay, so it's not as easy as plugging into the DLC. We have to go under the hood and find this diagnostic connector and hook up our special adapters. All right, here's the setup. At the battery, we have our cigarette lighter adapter, then the power cable going to the toy one adapter, then adapts to the actual wireless module for the Varus. And here's our diagnosis port. So this sucker plugs right in here. Okay, now we'll turn the key on. Okay, everything's hooked up. We got the green light. Continue. Okay, how to get codes. Key on, engine off, select auto code read. Okay, so auto code read. Cross your fingers. Gathering codes. And all right, cool. We have a code. Code number 12. Driver's squib circuit short to battery positive. Passenger airbag squib short to ground. That just popped up. Left side belt tensioner short to ground. Driver's squib circuit short to ground. Why are we getting so many codes? Is that it? Wow. Okay, let's go back. How do we clear codes? Codes will be cleared when airbag lamp is off. Just want to make sure that these are hard faults. They should be. So airbag light is flashing. Okay, it's off. Let's auto code read again. No codes present. Well, that was weird. Go back. Okay, so key off. Okay, airbag light is currently off. Okay. Turn the key on. Let's read the codes again. Very strange. That's the auto code read. No codes present. So, what do we do in this case? I still want to get to the airbag module, unplug everything, and do a resistance check on the driver's airbag, the passenger's airbag, just to make sure the resistances are within spec, and check the connections, because these airbag circuits are so sensitive to, like terminal fretting. That resistance needs to be within a tenth of an ohm. If it's not, it's going to start setting codes. So if we unplug everything and everything checks out, we'll spray it with deoxit, plug it back in, and I mean, we've fixed more than one airbag light this way, so I'm pretty sure it's going to be no parts required. So here's a wiring diagram of the airbag circuit. There is our module, and we're interested in airbag squib steering wheel pad. That's the driver's side airbag. So these two pins, yellow, I guess B, black and yellow, and then front passenger airbag assembly, yellow, red, and yellow, green. It should be on the same connector. Let's do a couple resistance measurements. All right, so right by the accelerator pedal, Toyota makes it easy. Peel back the carpet and there is our airbag module. So with the key off, I just want to unplug all of the connectors. So there's three of them. Let's see if I can get in here. There's one. Oh yeah, we got some water intrusion. Absolutely. There's two. Oh, a lot of green crusties. That's not good. And there's three. Oh man. All three connectors have oxidation on them. That's not good. So what we could do is get this module out of here and try to clean up those connectors the best we can, but where's the water coming from? It could just be moisture. It's kind of a down low. Here's the heater core. It doesn't look like it's leaking. I don't see any signs of drips, and this plastic cover, I mean, it's right over the module, so it shouldn't be wicking any moisture in there. But we definitely see some green crusties. That's a shame. Well, we're just gonna do it the quick and dirty. Deoxit everywhere. Let it sit a little bit. And then we'll just blow it out with compressed air right in the module there. I guess it's looking better. I'll give it one more round. Hopefully it'll heal it at least temporarily. All right, everything's plugged in. Measuring the resistance on driver's side circuit, about 3 ohms. That's good. So I'm just back probing the module, because if you unplug it, then the shorting bar just shorts everything out and you get 0 ohms. So this is the easiest way to check the resistance here. Let's check the front passenger airbag. So we'll move our leads to the next circuit over, which is those two wires, right? Let's see if I can get them in there. There's one. It's a little tight with the camera here. The red and the green. Get that guy in there. Okay, here we go. About 2.8 ohms. All right, let's see if we fix this thing. Key on. Start her up. Airbag lays out. Let's do a final code scan. All right. So no codes for now. Definitely found the root cause of the problem. Some moisture intrusion in that airbag module and the connectors. I don't know why they don't seal those connectors up better, because the module is kind of sitting low, you know, could be exposed to the salt and the moisture where the passenger's feet are, or the driver's feet. And, you know, after 20 years and in faithful service, he might have some problems. But we'll make sure to tell the customer that this is potentially could reoccur, even though we, you know, sprayed the whole thing. The moisture should stay out of there for at least for a while. But, you know, if the moisture got into the module, there could be issues down the road. But quick and easy, and no parts required, just the way we like it here. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a quick follow-up on the Toyota Camry airbag module corrosion diagnosis that we did. I talked to the customer, and she said that this airbag light came on after she left her window open in Texas during a torrential downpour. So indeed, the interior of the car got wet, and apparently it took a while to dry out, and any exposed connector with constant voltage on it, you're going to see the green crusties. It's not a good situation. So that car, you know, it might be dry now, but those green crusties, they don't sleep. It, you know, you might have other problems down the road. So my recommendation for her was, you know, the car's fine now. Use for the HVAC system to keep the interior dry, put it on outside air, and put the heat on the floor so it kind of dries out the carpets more, and kind of, you know, hopefully it'll be good from now on. But that was the follow-up, that was the story, that's why the connectors are green. And thanks a lot for watching. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.